Oh, it's you. I told you on the phone she won't go with you.
Now, Hilda, I just want to talk to her.
She don't want to talk to you. She even made me stop buying your paper. And besides, someone's come to take her to the charity ball.
I'll force my way in.
If you do, she told me to throw a pitcher of water plumb in your face.
I'll risk it.
It was orders, but I used distilled water.
Do you and Elsa live this way all the time?
Well, I've done my best. She's in the living room, but I warn you, y'all better not go in there. She's in a nasty mood, and when I says nasty, I ain't missing words.
Hilda, I thought I told you to keep him out.
Elsa, please. I've never run after a woman before. That is, I've never admitted it, but I'm running after you.
Mm. You're on a treadmill, Mr. Ames. You may keep on running, but you'll remain in the same spot.
Hilda, for Pete's sake, will you get out of here? I've got things to say. I can't say them when you're standing there staring at me.
Hilda, you stay right where you are.
You don't know what's good for you.
Listen, before I knew you, I disliked you intensely. When I met you, I disliked you intensely. Even now, I dislike you intensely. That is the sensible, sane portion of me. But there's an insane side of me that gets a little violent every time I think of you.
Getting rid of a million-dollar lawsuit wouldn't have anything to do with your change in affection, would it?
You are a nasty creature, aren't you? But in time, I'll beat it out of you.
Reckon that's your date, honey, child.
I know why you're going to the ball. I also know that Sheila Lane is chairwoman of the entertainment committee and hasn't missed one of these affairs in 5 years, and she might show up. So you see, I'm going for the same reason you are.
I'm going because I'm charitably inclined.
Well, if that's your mood, go with me. I'll let you pay the cab fare.
Hello, Harold. I'll be ready in a moment.
Very glad to have met you, Harold. Drop in again sometime. We'll have another heart-to-heart talk.